Hi everyone, in this video we will share about cervical myelopathy condition. Cervical myelopathy is characterized by compression of cervical spinal cord at cervical level. For example, on the MRI picture, it shows the compression of spine at cervical level. Cervical myelopathy is usually developed due to cervical spondylosis, cervical stenosis, herniated disc, tumor, and ossification of the posterior longitudinal ligament or PLL. It is most common occur in elderly aged over 55 years old. It affects both male and female equally and common in Asia. OPLL is the common cause in Asia, while cervical spondylosis occur earlier in men rather than women.
The clinical features of the condition are decreased feeling in fingertips, lead to difficulty using hand for small tasks, tingling or pain in the fingers, especially the thumb, index and middle fingers, dropping objects, unable to perform delicate motions such as buttoning a shirt, weakness in the hand, and numbness at night. The way to diagnose cervical myelopathy are through MRI and provocative tests such as Klonus sign, Hoffman sign, and Babinski reflex. The first one is Klonus sign, which will dorsiflex the patient's foot, and positive response is when the foot starts to bounce at least 3 times. The second test is Hoffman sign, which is done by flicking the nail of middle or ring finger, and the test is positive when there is a clear adduction of thumb and flexion of index finger. The last test is Babinski reflex, which is done by running a pointer object along the lateral border of the foot from the calcaneus towards the great toe. The test is positive when the patient produces an extension of the big toe and abduction of other toes. The other way to diagnose cervical myelopathy is through MRI, which can express the amount of compression placed on the spinal cord and demonstrate relatively high levels of sensitivity and specificity. The pathophysiology of cervical myelopathy largely involves compressive forces on the spine due to a combination of static factors, which result in acquired or developmental stenosis of the cervical canal. Next is dynamic factor, which involves repetitive injury to the cervical cord and can cause dynamic pressure on the cord when flexing and extending. The last pathophysiology is vascular aspect of the spinal cord, which is ischemia as a major underlying pathology event contributing to myelopathy. Oligodendrocyte respond poorly to ischemia, and this may explain the demyelination that occurs with chronic cervical myelopathy.
So what are the treatment given to cervical myelopathy patients? The treatment can be divided into conservative or surgical treatment. For conservative management, doctor can prescribe patient with anti-inflammatory medication, or the best choice is by having a surgery. Anti-inflammatory medication may have some short-term benefit in relieving the painful symptoms of shoulder or limbs. People who have progressive neurologic changes with signs of severe spinal cord compression or swelling are candidates for surgery. The aim of the surgery is decompression of the spinal cord with or without the instrument fusion. As an OT, we contribute into patient's treatment after the surgery. First, we assess patient motor function and their performance ability in ADL, high ADL, work or leisure, and then identify what is the most valued occupation they want to improve. For example, restore the patient's hand dexterity to by tension and hold a cup. We also can educate patients to practice good neck posture by keeping their head and neck upright when reading, for example. The prognosis for this condition is it tends to be progressive and get worse, but prognosis for recovery is better in patients with early surgery. After a surgery, they may not recover further, but it will stop the progression of the disease and perhaps there will be some recovery, and it depends on the severity of the disease itself.
What are the impairments experienced by cervical myelopathy patients? The first one is decreased range of motion in cervical spine. Next, experience pain at neck and arm area. And lastly, numbness and paresthesia in one or both hands. Person with cervical myelopathy experience some functional limitation. The first one is difficulty to perform fine motor activities such as writing and buttoning shirt. The second one is having weakness of grip strength such as unable to hold coffee cup and difficulty to grip pencil.